So, welcome, and happy to be here. There's some great sessions already, and nice for you to take some time to attend on this Saturday. Let's start with the question. Do you actually recognize the logo on the top left of the screen? It's the logo, Powerful Alone and Better Together. I'm going to explain what it is in a minute. But first, let me explain why it's there and why I want to tell you about this session that I have. So back in the day when in-person conferences were still a thing, I attended the Power Platform Summit Europe in Amsterdam back in 2019. And one of the sessions there was a workshop where the presenters had a sort of a quiz. And the attendees had to answer, try to answer the questions about the Power BI governance and administration. And the first one with the right answer could come up on stage and demo it, and also got awarded some points. And to keep track of the points, the speakers created a Power App visual inside a Power BI dashboard. And that's the way they could keep the score live on the screen. So that's actually the solution that I'm going to show you today. And I never really thought about that solution until the Power Platform Better Together contest came up. That was last year around May, around the Business Application Summit. And the logo that you see on the top left is actually the winner of that Better Together contest. That was a contest about making the best visual of combining all the products, and well, that was the winning contest. So first, let me thank all the sponsors of this event for making it happen, and also the organizers and all the volunteers working in the background to making this a wonderful event, and also to you attendees, of course, because you take a time out of your personal schedule to attend these sessions. So I already put a link in the chat. It would be nice if you could go to that link. So it's a bit.ly link. And if you enter that bit.ly link, then you will end up at this nice form I made in Microsoft Forms. And by answering these four questions about you, I know a little bit about you, and I can show you those answers later in this Power BI dashboard. So it's a quite similar setup that I am going to explain today. Today I'm using a Power App and Power Automate to show it in Power BI, and this solution uses Forms and Power Automate into Power BI streaming dataset. So it's quite similar, but a little bit different. So let's first introduce myself. I'm Nicky van Voenhoven. I work at Van Lanschot Kempen. That's a wealth manager in the Netherlands. And I work there at the data warehouse team. So we make sure that all the source systems are refreshing their data into the corporate data warehouse every day. And next to that, I'm also the Power BI administrator for our company. So I deal a lot with training people in Power BI, explaining them the best practices and conventions, naming conventions, for example, that we have, but also topics around the governance and administration of Power BI. And more we also use the other products of the Power Platform, so Power Automate, Power Apps. I'm also very active online on Twitter, on my blog. And I'm also a moderator at the Power BI forum, so the community.powerbi.com. And since July of last year, I'm also a Microsoft MVP for the data platform. So that's a nice honor to be included in that family. So let's see if you have any responses more. So it's just Laura and me for now. Ah, there they are. So we have the most from UK and Belgium. That's good. So I think two here and two there. Yeah, that's okay. And let's look at the experience. So a little bit less streaming data, but some nice Power Apps and Power BI, and also some integrations. Okay, that's good. Well, thanks for joining me, and then I will come back to this dashboard later. Maybe that we have a few more answers there. So first, let's have a look at my final solution, what I'm going to accomplish today. What you see here is a Power BI dashboard. And on the left side of the screen, you see a Power Apps visual where I can enter a name and a score, and I can push a button, and then it gets updated on the right side of the screen. And you see, oh, one second. Sorry about that. Kids joining the presentation. Not always good. Okay, so on the right side you see the visual for the report. That gets updated with the visuals of your Power Apps. So Power Platform is made up of Power BI, where you can analyze your data, Power Apps, where you can act on it with low-code or no-code apps, Power Automate to process, to automate the processes, and of course chatbots also in Power Virtual Agents. And let's see what we are going to use today. So we are using Power BI Streaming Dataset to gather the data, so to enter the data. And I'm going to create an instant flow in Power Automate. I'm going to create a Canvas Power App to embed in the Power BI report, and also a Power BI report, and on top of that, a Power BI dashboard. And the Power BI dashboard is very important because that takes care of the live refresh of the data inside the Power BI visual, as you will see later on. So enough slides for now. Let's go right into the demos. So let's switch to here, and then go there's one more. Let's go here to Power BI. First, we are going to create a streaming data set. So I'm in my workspace. It could be any workspace, but I'm just going to my workspace, and I'm going to create a streaming data set over here. I'm choosing the API version, choosing next, and then I'm going to give this a name. Let's call it Demo for Scottish Summit. And I just can give a name for my for the fields that I want to use in the streaming data set. I'm going to give the first one a date. I can use that actually for example, filtering values that I'm testing and that I don't want to have in the other visual, or to have a unique column in the data set that I can later filter on, for example. So there's only three data types that you can use in a streaming data set. So it's either text, number, or datetime. And of course, this is going to be datetime. Then I also want to have the name. That's going to be text, but it's okay. And I want to have the score, and that will be a number. And you see an example of the values that you could enter. Last important thing is turning the historic data analysis on, because that will make sure that the data will stay in the data set until I delete it manually. Otherwise, the data will only be available for around 30 seconds. So that's not enough for this demo. So I'm going to create this and click done. And then we should have our new, let's see here, demo SS. So that's my new data set. So I'm good here. Let's go to flow and create a new flow. And I want to have an instant flow, because it will be triggered by by Power Apps. So a Power Apps button will trigger the flow to kick off the flow. So I'm going to choose Power Apps, and I'm going to give it the same name to be consistent. I'm going to create it. And that's actually everything we need to do for Power Apps. There's no additional steps that we need to take here. And the next step I want to do is take my data from Power Apps and put it in Power BI streaming dataset. So I'm searching for Power BI, and then I'm choosing the add rows to a dataset. It's still in preview, but it has been there for quite a while now. And you have to choose a workspace, of course. So I'm choosing my workspace. That's the workspace where I created the streaming dataset. Then I'm choosing the dataset. It's called Demo Scottish Summit. And then the table will always be real-time data, because that's the name that the workspace gives to the streaming dataset. So it's nothing that you can choose. And then after a few seconds, the names of the fields will display. So the names of the streaming dataset that I created. And then when you click inside the field of the date column, you can give it an expression. And you can either choose to send the date from Power Apps, or you can choose to populate it here. And I'm just going to do it here. Going to choose the UTC now, and that will be sent to the date. The name will actually come from Power Apps, because I'm creating a field in Power Apps later. So what I do is I click on Ask in Power Apps, and that will give me a parameter that will be created here to use inside of Power Apps. So it's called add rows to a dataset underscore name. I'm going to do the same for the score field. I'll just have to click see more, then the Ask in Power Apps will come back, and it will create a second parameter. So add rows to data set underscore score. So I have name, score, and a date. So I'm actually all set here. So I'm clicking save. And that's good. It's ready to go. If the flow checker gives you a red dot, then you might have a warning or an error. So that's worth checking. For now, I can just test it. I'm going to just test it manually. And just have to click continue to sign in. And I can just add some values here to the name. So I'm just going to enter my name, give myself 10 points, and then say run flow. So it successfully started. That's one thing. But let's see if it also ran fine. So I'm going to the flow history. It should be green. It succeeded. That's good. And if I click on the details, I can actually see what happened inside the flow. So it's not that difficult, because we have just two steps. And then over here we see the date, the name, and the score. And this is UTC time, so that's or GMT. So that's correct. So it's set. It's successful, and it added rows to a data set, but let's check if it also did that, actually. So let's go to Power BI Desktop. I'm going to connect to a Power BI data set. And I have to wait a few seconds for the window to pop up. Then I'm going to search for my workspace. I'm just waiting patiently for the window to come up. Should be there in a few seconds, normally. I'm just waiting. I know if I click anywhere, then it will certainly break. So this once I'm not going to do that. And otherwise, I'm just going to continue to Power Apps, and we'll come back to this later. It might come up now. Yeah, there it is. Right, thank you. So I'm searching for my workspace, and then going to the demo SS. So this is the dataset, streaming dataset that I created in my own workspace. It also says 5 minutes ago. I'm going to create the connection. And it takes a few seconds. And I can show you, I'm just going to put it over here so it's not in the way of my my own camera. And it says it's connected live to the Power BI dataset. So that's good. I have a live connection now. So let's see if there are actually rows in the dataset, because that's what Flow said, but I want to see it for myself, of course. So it's getting the data now. And I do see as there's data, the scores I entered, and the time also. So that's good. This this part is working. So now let's close this history. I don't need that anymore. Let's go to the next step. It's going to be Power Apps. So I'm going to create a Canvas app just from blank. You can also use some of the templates that are already here. So lots of templates that you can use that are that have some functionality out of the box, for example, that you can use. But for now, I'm just going to create an app from blank. The name will be the same. And I'm just going to create this one. And for this, it will be a very simple app. I will just need two fields to input some text and a button and maybe some more enhancements later. But let's start with the basics. And for starters, the first thing I'm going to do is resize my screen a little bit so it will get a little bit bigger. And don't forget to hit apply here. Thank you. Because otherwise it won't save anything. And you can also change the name and the icon, for example, if you want to have a nice purple color and a check mark, for example. And that's it for now. Let's save it again here already. Then we don't have to do that later. Okay, that's cool. So the first thing I want to do is insert a text field, so text input, where I can enter some data. So first I'm going to increase the font size a little bit, so it's better readable. And what I usually do in this case is don't give it a default text, but give it a hint text. So I'm deleting the text input and give it a hint text of name. And that will be here. And then if you enter the field, the hint text will be gone automatically. So let's make it a little bit smaller. Also, give the control a proper name, which is name in this case. And well, that's actually all for now. Let's copy this one and put it here and name this score. And also change this one to score. And then we have the two text inputs for name and score. And the next thing we want is a button, because we want to click the button and save the values to my streaming data set. So clicking save. We also name the control, save, and what size is it? 15. Let's also make it 20. And I'm fine with the color for now. So this is the most basic app that I can create. Now I'm going to go to action, and from there I can choose to incorporate Power Automate, so flows to this app. And you have to have the button selected and then click on Power Automate, and that will show a list of flows that you have, and the demo SS one is the one that I need. So I'm going to click this one, and this will be added to my button. And after a few seconds, you will see a formula pop up here. If everything's going okay. And I just have to do some coding there to make this happen. So let's close this one for a second. So what you see over here, let's do it over here. So we are in the onSelect property of this button. So when I select it or click it for that matter, then this code will be run. So what we see here are the two parameters that I created in flow. So the add rows to a dataset, underscore name and underscore score. So I will first have to get the data from the name input. So from this input into that parameter. So that's going to be name. This is the control. And I want the text from the name. So that's good. And then for my second parameter, I'm going to do the same. I'm going to get score.text. But the thing is, the score, I created that as a number in my streaming data set. So I have to get the value from the score. And that will actually, I'm just going to get my, let me check. Yeah, now it's showing. I want to get this, the data type that is now converted to number. So value score.txt is now converted to a number. So that's matching my streaming data set. So that's good. And this is now everything I want to do for the most basic app that I want to create. So I can actually go over here to the play button and preview the app. And let's give myself another point. I click on save. And if you look closely at the top of the screen, you will see some processing going on. So there are the points. But you have to look very closely to see that it actually did anything. If I now click again, then it will save it again. So, no, I didn't know that. To make it a little bit more visible, I'm going to add some things to the report, to the app, to make it a better understanding in what's happening. So let's refresh this for a second and see if the row actually was added to the dataset. Well, it was, and as you see, it was added twice. So if you don't have a visual confirmation that it was saved, then it's hard to see that it did. So if you keep clicking the button, then it will actually be saved many times. So the next thing I want to do first is, let's run it once more. If I click save, then the same values will still be in here after clicking save. So the first thing I want to do is after clicking the save button. So I'm pressing shift enter. That will give me a new line. I'm going to reset the controls. So reset the name and also shift enter, reset the score control. And let's quickly see what it does. I'm going to give the value of 2 now. And clicking save, that will clear the two text inputs and give me a proper name and score hint again. So that's one step better, I think. But it would also be nice to have a notification that my score was saved somewhere. So that the clicking of the button also did anything. And for that, let me check. I'm going to add a label underneath the button. So I'm clicking insert and the label is over here. So I'm choosing label, putting it underneath the button. Also the font size can be a little bit bigger. Doesn't have to be 20, but 15 is good. Let's give it the text of score saved. Let's center it nicely and maybe give it a bit of a nicer color. Um, Let's do the purple one. Okay. So that's good. The last thing I want to do is also name the control properly. So score saved. So I know what I'm working with. And the next thing I'd like to do is enable this label, because it doesn't have to be visible all the time, only when I click the button. So the next thing I want to do is edit this this onSelect code again. So I'm adding a new line to it to show the label after I click the button. So what I'm doing is using set to that's wrong one, to set the value of a variable. And you can just create the variable when you're setting it. So I'm using a GV for a global variable. That's something I picked up from the from YouTube channel. It's the Viral Apps for Kids channel. It's actually a pretty good channel. And it's for little kids, but also for big kids. So I learned a few things from there. And let's call this, what name should I give it? Show label, to keep it consistent. Show label. So that's the name of my variable. And I want to set this to true after I click the button. So that's what's happening here. It first resets the controls, then it sets my variable to true. If I now click out of the onSelect property, I can also, if I go to file and variables over here, see that I have this variable defined, and it still has no value because it's not initialized, so I haven't used the form yet. But I can see where that variable is used and what it's doing exactly. So it's only defined now, but you can also use it later on. So that will be in the next parts that I do that. So now it's set to true after I push the button. And what I also want to do is at the startup of the form, set the visibility to invisible. So set the visibility to false. So actually I'm going to the visible property of the label itself. It's now set to true. And I actually want to set this to the value of the global variable. So this is a Boolean value. So it's either true or false. And it's now false because it's not initialized yet. So that's why the label and the text in it is disappearing now. So that's good for now. So let's see what's happening now if we use the form. Just using myself again. Let's give me 3 points now. Clicking save. So the controls will reset. The score is saved. But now when I click name again, then the score saved is still there. Right, so you see what's the problem. Let's do 5 now. So the label is still there. So there's one thing more I need to do. When I'm clicking name or score, but mostly clicking name because that's on the top, I want to have the label disappear. So for that, I would use the onSelect property of the name. So the onSelect of the name. And I can again set any variable to a certain value. So again, I'm using set. I want to set my show label global variable, and I want to set it to false here, because when I click the control, I want to disable, or at least don't show the visual, the label. So this is the onSelect of the name, yes. And let's also do this for the score. So if you accidentally click the score first, then it will also disappear. So the onSelect, clicking it, and setting the variable to false. So let's see what this does. So it's still there now, but whenever I click here, it should disappear. Let's give myself again 1 point. and the score is saved. And now clicking name, it will disappear. Let's give Laura also some points. She would be interested. Let's give her 5 and the score is there. And also when I click score, then it's also disappeared. So it's pretty good for now. I won't say it's the best looking app, but it's working for me now. So that's good. I'm not going to worry about the layout or visualization right now. That's for another demonstration. So for now, I'm going to save this one so I can use it later. Publish it. Yes. Let me check real quick if I didn't forget anything. No, it's okay. So actually, I'm going to close this one, and I'm going to explain later why I didn't do that. So now I'm returning to Power BI Desktop. I'm just going to refresh this one to see that all the values are there. So it should have like 10 or 15 rows, I think. A little bit less. Okay, it looks good. So the last one's from Laura, so that's good. And for now, actually, let's delete this one. The first thing I want to do is incorporate the Power Apps for Power BI visual. That's out of the box in Power BI for now. So I'm going to click this one. And that will give me the Power Apps visual. And it actually explains what you need to do. So how to get started with Power Apps inside Power BI. So you first select the fields from your data that you want to use in Power Apps. So that's actually going to be name and score. And after that, you want to, there it is. I was waiting for this screen to happen. You want to choose an existing app or create a new one. So as I already created one, I will choose the app. And you have to also take care of the environment here. So this is my my default environment. Otherwise, you'll have to switch to the right environment. So this is the one, Demo SS. I'm adding it here. And that will actually have my app inside the report already. But there's one thing I need to do. And it also says here, to finalize the connection between Power Apps and Power BI, you have to go to Power App Studio again. And then you have to open the Power App there. So that's why I close it earlier. Otherwise, I would get a warning that it's already open in edit mode. And well, now it opens up my Power App. And if you look closely here on the left side, on the top of the controls, next to my 4 controls, there will be a Power BI integration popping up in just a few seconds. Maybe I can zoom in a little bit and hope I have the right place. And still doing something.
Just while that's loading, we've got a question for you.
Okay.
Is there a way to have the label display with a time condition, e.g. 10 seconds, and then disappear?
That's a very good question. I don't know how, but...
Okay, let me... Do you mind if I answer it?
Yeah, sure, do.
Yes, there is a way of doing it. The way the variable that Nikki showed to make it show, you could also have a timer put in there.
Ah, cool. Okay.
Okay, back to you.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. And well, the app loaded now, and we see over here the Power BI integration. So that's the connection between Power BI and your Power App. So that's good. And the rest of the control is still untouched. So this is good. The only thing I need to do now is I thought I'd to save it also, but that's good. Very good. Then I can go back to Power BI Desktop and create a visual out of my data. So I'm going to use the stacked column chart for this. I'm going to explain in a little bit why. So name and score, of course, and the values. So there we have the the two scores of me and Laura. And the reason why I choose this one is if I add the name to the legend, then you get a nice different colors. For example, if I add another one, Mark, let's give him 10 points for now. Let's save it. And for now, I have to refresh because I'm still in Power BI Desktop. It doesn't update automatically. There we go. And this makes sure that every name in the dataset has a different color. And I also have a thick bars, so nice thick bars. And for example, if I use the cluster column charts, I have the same layout when I don't have the legend enabled, but when I enable this one, then I get these small bars. So that's, I don't, I like this view very much. So that's why I choose this one and then get the name and the legends. So you can properly differentiate the names and the scores. So they're actually good in Power BI Desktop. Let's move to the service now. So you have around 8 minutes left, so we should be good. Let's do it in my workspace. And let's go to the final part of the solution. Because I mentioned earlier, the important part is creating a Power BI dashboard. So now I only have a report. So the next step is pinning the two visuals I have to a dashboard. And that's what I'm going to do now. So this will be my report. Just waiting a few seconds to pop up there. And let me go back to my slides first. I have a few slides with some things I learned. So the first one is that you also can enter values below zero. So minus 10 or minus 20, for example. That could come in handy, for example, if you make a typing error. For if you want to add 10 points to Laura, for example, and you accidentally type in 100, so a zero too much, then you can type minus 90 afterwards and then even that out. So that works pretty well. But the thing you can't do is delete names from the dataset. You can give it a zero score, but then the name will still be in the dataset. So you can't really delete it. You can give it 0 points and then it doesn't have a bar, but the name will still be in the dataset. And an important part is also when you combine different connectors together, so the Power Apps and the Power BI connector, is the data loss prevention policy. And I will come back to that in a second. Let's first check if the report is ready. Not yet. Let's refresh it. Ah, there it is. Cool. And the app should come up in a few seconds. It's loading. Ah, and now I pressed refresh. Okay. Let's go back here for a second then, because the data loss prevention policy, let's view this policy for now, that takes care of securing your business data, actually, and it, you can access it from the Power Platform Admin Center. You have to be a Power Platform administrator for that, to do that, or a global admin. And in this data loss prevention policy, you actually have three buckets. So the business, the non-business, and the blocked. And you can't use connectors together that are in different buckets. So if you look at the business bucket, this is mostly Office 365 and Teams, Power BI, that sort of thing, SQL Server. So we can all use these connectors together. So if you look at Power BI, that's there. And also, what did I use? Power Apps, of course. And I will assume that's also there, no, not here. But we also have Microsoft Teams, for example, and also Power Automate. And if you look at the non-business bucket, so for example, let's say I want to send out a tweet every time I fill in the my Power app. In this policy, that's not possible because the Twitter connector is in the non-business bucket. So I can't use that with the Power BI connector, for example, because that's in the business bucket. So you either have to convince the Power Platform administrator to put the Twitter one into the business bucket or use a different solution. So that's one thing to take care of. And you also get a notification about the data loss prevention policy being being active. So if you get that error, then you know what to do, or at least who to go to. And it says it's there. Said that last time. Ah, there it is. Okay. So this is my report. The next thing I like to do is create a dashboard out of it. So let's create a new one. Give it the name demo. It's got a Shemit. That's one. And also pin this one to an existing dashboard. Pin and go to the dashboard. Okay, let's rearrange it a little bit to make this over here. I make this a little bit bigger so we properly see it. Let's do it this way. And now we can test it and see what happens. So let's give the other people a little bit more points. Let's see, 10, so let's give them 30 points. And without refreshing, it might take a few seconds, but I'm saying should refresh automatically without doing anything. Let's give Laura also some more points. And it's back again. And there it is. It was just busy setting it up, I think. So there it is. Laura now has 45 points, and Mark 40. And if you keep adding, okay, that's wait a second. The Power Apps Visual sometimes has to reinitialize, so that's why it's it wasn't working there. I'm going back to my dashboard again. Let's wait 1 second, and otherwise, there is demo SS dashboard. That's the one. Yeah, there is. Great. So, for example, let me show you. If I give myself minus 23 points, then you see the bar disappears. But you should see the bar disappear. But my name still is in the data set, so that's why you can give it a value of zero or even minus 10 if you want, but you can't delete the data. I just have to click once. See, that's strange. Wasn't happening on my computer. Ah, okay, now it's working. It's up to date, I think. Okay, so for example, if I give minus 11 points, that also works, and I just have minus one. And you keep adding people to the list, and they get a nice different color every time you add add new people. So that's good. I see we have 1 minute left, so I'm right on time, I think. I explained the data loss prevention policy. Make sure to check that out if you have any issues with setting up the Power Automate flow, so that you will get that issue in the flow. If you have different buckets. I also have some resources you might want to check out. I have a walkthrough of this solution, so Power Apps, Automate, and Power BI in two blog posts. And I also explained how I did the setting up the form in my in the beginning of the dashboard, which I might go back to for a second. So that's this one. So using forms, then Power Automate, and then Power BI streaming dataset. To show this nice interactive dashboard that you can use for the start of a presentation, for example. And I mentioned the Power Apps for Kids YouTube channel. It's a great resource, not only for kids. And now this is more of a, how shall I say this? A personal example of using integrations, but for business scenarios, for example, you can use Writeback. Power BI report, so using a Power App to write back data to the database and then refreshing it automatically with a direct query in your report. You could also use Flow to validate email attachments automatically. So certain conditions are met, then validate and maybe extract the email and put it into a SharePoint list, for example. And you can also refresh a Power BI dataset with Flow. So there's an action called refresh a dataset that you can use to do that inside of Power Automate. And also a lot more integrations mentioned at the Power Platform integrations forum over at the community at Power BI. So if you want to have a look at that, please do. And with that, I'd like to say thank you and let's connect.